doing 10 million in 2015, but yeah, between now and March, and given that we've got
evaluated, but we believe that the amount that we're talking about today will constitute the upper limit of what we need to finish this project off, including the final cost.
Well, the good news is that the project, the TYSSE project, is now 80% complete. Most of the stations are in an advanced state of completion. We're already installing escalators, putting in tiling. In fact, the track's nearly all in, so we remain on target for completion by the end of next year. In just 24 short months, we will have a state-of-the-art subway extending up into York Region. It's important that people understand why it is that the TYSSE, the Spadina extension, got into the problems that it did, because they are far more complex than just saying, well, the TTC messed up the project management. It's way more complex than that. If we look right back to the start of the project, back in 2007, 2008, the TTC was ready to start, but the critical funding for the project was delayed by 18 months with delays with federal funding, and there were also a lot of there was a lot of delay incurred because of debate about what the stations should look like. The TTC wanted to build very rudimentary box-type structures, such as are featured on the Shepherd Line. But at the time, it was felt that there needed to be much more architecturally spectacular designs. So that led to further delay. That delay was never reflected in an extension of either the schedule or the budget. So for a myriad of reasons, including contractor performance and various other factors, we are where we are today. I cannot turn the clock back on that. What I can do is take decisive action, which I did, to bring in a third party, namely Bechtel, to do two things. Get us across the line end of 2017, which is on track, and limit the overrun, the cost overrun, to the absolute minimum.
But as I said before, this is the final bill coming in for a lot of those mistakes of the past, and the good news is that we've got this project back on track and moving ahead.
So in order to settle some of these old claims, we are budgeting an amount at the City of Toronto side of $240 million. And so while that's not a decision that the TTC makes, we've obviously deliberating on that strategy going forward. And now that work begins now because we want to make sure that we get the best deal for Toronto taxpayers and work to make sure these claims are less than that and as little as possible. And so that's work begins now. But to get the project done, to get it back on track, we have to settle these claims.